My colleague, the Minister of Devolution in Kenya, is Cabinet Secretary. Dear participants, ladies and gentlemen, my name is John Byabagambi, very long name. My colleague has talked about the coexistence between different groups of people around the borders. But me, I bring in practical example of how investment and entrepreneurship can be the catalyst for peace and development. And this is in Karamoja. I don't have a map of Uganda here. Karamoja region and the Turkana, they are just northwest of Uganda. And I think for Kenya, no, northeast of Uganda, and Kenya is northwest. And these people, they speak the same language. And they are called Atekere group. They are found in Uganda, found in Kenya, South Ethiopia, and South Sudan. Why a cabinet minister for Karamoja? It is clear this is the area that had land behind due to war, conflicts, and the cattle wrestling. And that was their hope. Or that's why they drive the arrival of violence for income, stealing cows from one another. And that's how they lived for a long time. And I agree with my colleague here. I think the first human being was from that area. And they evolved such a tools of violence, spears, quads. It all started from that. It all started from that. So, what did the government of Uganda do? They have to create a ministry of those for Karamoja affairs, but also develop a program to respond to those issues. And this program was designed and was called Karamoja Integrated Disarmament and Development Plan. You can imagine these guys have more than 45,000 lethal weapons. Those are small arms, AK-47s. And then they come from South Sudan, from everywhere. Now, what was this program going to do? One, was supposed to disarm all the Karamojans, then stabilize the area, then reconstruct the infrastructure in that area, then ensure food security, because also there was a lot of hunger and productivity, then development. We had to remove 40,000 guns from these people, which were covered. Forcefully, initially it was persuasion. And they brought about 10% of them. They were hiding others. But then the government had to come in with the army to force these people to surrender the guns. So we took all the guns from the Karamojans. But after taking the guns from them, we had put in place programs for development and see how we can sustain that security. So we had to construct roads. And by that time, I was the minister in charge of roads. So I've been in that ministry for 10 years, works on transport, first as the Minister of State, then later on as a full cabinet minister. We had to construct the roads, and that's how we managed to open the road between Moroto and road work. And let alone embark on upgrading them to tarmac levels. And as we talk of now, about three quarters, about 75% of the roads, main ones, are already tarmac. So you can move from here up to Moroto on tarmac roads, which is a very, very big achievement. That's about 550 kilometers from here. They don't have to extend electricity there. Then recently we are creating industrial parks in that area. We have put in place a lot of projects. One, peace recovery and development plan is in place. And we have put agro-pastoralist resilience programs like NADS, Operation Wealth Creation, all that is down here in Karamoja. Now, Karamoja is a region endowed with minerals. There is a lot of economic activities going on now. Mining, tourism, we have got the best national parks in this country situated in Karamoja, Kidepo Valley National Park, game reserves. We have put in place markets on a daily basis, livestock markets, and we have also started processing and value addition some of the crops that they are producing. Now, what is this role, the role of entrepreneurship and investment in this progress? We have started about 300 business startups in Karamoja for the last 4 years. We have created microfinance centers, especially the youth, to engage the youth so that they are productive and get them from over drinking and the looking for cows, etc. We developed a program of labor intensive public works. And these are repairing the roads, especially Maram roads. Most of people, they call them mud roads, using paws and hands and what have you. We engage in these people. And I am employing more than 35,000 youth and women on these roads. On one hand, they get an income. On the other hand, they repair the roads. But the most important thing is peace. Peace development, to make sure that they are engaged and they occupy. They used to depend on only grain, that is sorghum, maybe, and millet, and maize sometimes. But these people have introduced other types of crops, legumes and tubers. Now they produce cassava, potato. So I can see that really the investment is bringing peace in Karamoja. Innovations are taking place, and now we have got venture capital through their microfinances. Employment has reduced the idleness, and we can see that we have stable community, we have closed the gaps, and we have reduced also the iniquity in these areas. Now, what is the impact of the entrepreneurship and investment in this region? The easy access to Karamoja has increased trade, communication, and integration of the region with the rest of the groups around the area. The more economic and business activities, therefore, they have created organic relationships and they have reduced conflict. Actually, in the Karamoja now, what is there is no longer the other conflict of stealing cows and etc., killing each other. It's like any other area of Uganda, maybe stealing a goat, maybe one cow, like any other area. You can't eradicate all these things completely. But that's what is in Karamoja now. There is social cohesion within the area and meaningful work. Violence in the Karamoja is almost no longer there. So, in the conclusion, we have now stable Karamoja, peaceful, and now it's going to become a next business hub and investment destination. Peace and stability of Karamoja has stimulated economic growth and development of the neighboring districts in Uganda and the regions surrounding it, like in Kenya. Actually, the business between Karamoja now and Turkana, especially the roadwork, is booming. It's booming. You can see a region where you could hardly move about 15 years ago. But today, you see a line of traders carrying goods either side. So you can see how the investment can bring peace. I know that security is essential, but entrepreneurship and investments are critical. Are critical for stable security and development, are critical for peace and stability to reign in any region, in any country. I thank you very much for listening to me, and for us in the Karamoja, we say, Kara Kara, no.